everybody, it's Elvira at the Doll Circle, and today I'm doing my, I don't know what I'm calling this tutorial, just yet, so once you guys see the title, hopefully I'll come up with something cute. I'm going to be taking the Haunted Doll, a doll from the Haunted line. I got her at Target on clearance, and I know a lot of people were saying about her face being plain, so what I'm going to do is create a face. We will see what happens. I'm going to actually leave the paint that's already on there because I'm not good at drawing lines, and I'm going to use the lines that are on here as some form of, like, layout for me to actually draw on. So we'll see how that goes, and then I'm going to change up her outfit and give her a cute little kawaii outfit, and I'll show you guys what I'm working with. Dun-dun-dun! Be prepared! I have a whole giant bin of crafting supplies because I love making stuff, so I'm going to use everything from jewels and other little pieces, so as I go through it, I'll definitely show you guys step by step, so let's begin!
Let's go! Yeah. I'm like an addict, do I gotta have it? I ain't even playing, got a really bad habit. If it moves, gotta grab it, fuse like a magnet. Lose, won't have it till I'm doomed in a casket. I ain't playing, got a weird mind. If you work 8 hours, I'ma work 9. If the shit tastes sour, you should taste mine. I'ma stay in power for a long time. Get up, nah, I ain't a quitter. Toss me the ball, I'm a really big hitter. Big picture, I'm a straight killer. Rising the song to the highest bidder. Got juice, got gas, I'ma move fast. New shoes, new tracks, like who's that? I'm new, come back, better than last. Yeah, it's a new me, never gonna look back. Never gonna look back. Cause damn, I was built to last. You move slow and I move fast. And that's facts. Only I can make a change. Slowly take a step today. I will never be the same. Cause that's what it takes.
So this is actually pretty fast, and again, why I kind of decided to go with some of the methods that I used was because A, I don't feel like I'm a super good crafter, and then also I wanted to show you guys that even if you're not a good crafter, you can still do something simple and make a custom your own. So let me get her a little closer so you guys can see her. Alright, so now for her face, I didn't use acrylics, I used these Sharpie pens, which you can find anywhere, and be very careful when you use them. They do rub and smear, so make sure to handle very, very carefully. And then also make sure to put a matte Mod Podge and dab it with a very soft brush over the lines of where you put the pen, just because it will, like I said, smudge even like an hour after. I learned the hard way. It made a mess. For her hair, I just brushed it down, put it in pigtails. I took these wired ribbon. Well, here, let me kind of spin her a little bit to the side. Wired ribbon, and I glued a button bow on it, and then put the wired ribbon around her. Her hair is a little frizzy, sticking out and stuff, but I'm gonna try to fix it later. Still looks really cute though for what it is. Decided to cut the sleeves off of her existing dress, and then I just added and embellished her normal dress. So I cut the sleeves off, glue one of these little, I call them puff balls. I think they're like crafting thing balls. I don't know what they are, but you can find them anywhere like at Michael's, where I did, and I bought a bag of pastel colored ones. Left her bracelet on. Decided to glue ribbon around her waist. Oh, again, no sewing in this either. So if you guys have hot glue gun, make sure to ask your parents first, for the younger viewers out there. If not, hot glue works. Obviously, to be more delicate, this is only going to be a display doll, not a play with doll. Play with dolls, you have to sew. So I took her purse, left the happy face on one side. On the sad face, I glued two puffy hearts on them, and you can find this again any craft location, and glued ribbon around the outside. Kind of more of a little cutesy touch. And then for her dress, here, I'll set the purse down so you can see. I cut off that one hanging piece that had like the flower print that was just like the sleeves because I didn't like it. Left this piece on, glued dark purple ribbon. Again, all the colors I kind of went with purples and light purples and darks and pinks and stuff. Ribbon there. And then I went around the whole entire outside with more of the little puffballs and gave it kind of like, again, I kind of was going for a cutesy kawaii look. And I'd have to say I'm really proud of these shoes. So I left her existing shoes. I like the socks. At first I didn't want to do it, but I like the socks a lot. Let me zoom in here and show you guys. I took ribbon and glued light and then dark around there and then more buttons in different color. This is purple bows versus her hair had pink. So really, really simple, and I left the back alone. I just thought I wanted to give a little embellishment to it, and I liked the kind of like ghosty color scheme of the shoes, because obviously she's, you know, hello, haunted family. So I wanted to leave that there. I was going to think about getting a bright shoe. I may eventually make more shoes or design more, but I kind of left it that way. Again, I'm really happy. Super simple craft. I mean, it took me a little while because I was experimenting and I didn't know exactly how I wanted her to look, but I really, really am happy with the overall outcome. Again, if you're using Sharpie pens, make sure to be very careful. That's my one thing that I've learned here today. Be very careful with Sharpie pens. I might eventually do acrylic. I just need better brushes, super fine tip. Maybe something like they use for Warhammer or something. I don't know. But again, if you guys are afraid of like customizing dolls, don't be, because I am. And like I said, gluing things are fine, and going simple sometimes has the best outcome. Again, I used existing stuff here, like her dress and her shoes, and I just embellished it. So comment below, let me know what you guys think. Maybe next time I'll make it a little harder on myself, doing some sewing or something like that, and maybe some acrylic paints, but let me zoom into her face and show you guys maybe a little closer what I did. Again, I used a dark pink for her lips, green for her eyes, accented with a pink line around the top part of her eye, and then I mixed blue and orange to get this weird brown color, for like a copper almost, for her eyebrows, and then black eyeliner for the eyeliner. So again, really, really simple. Comment below. Let me know what you guys think. Do you want to see more of this? I definitely am happy with her. I really, really like her outfit, and I can't wait to go cut up and glue some more dresses and share it with you guys. As always, thanks for watching. Make sure to check out our Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And I'm really proud of her. Again, cost me barely anything. All the craft stuff I already had, if not, realistically, it would cost me like 5-10 bucks in craft supplies and then the doll. So super worth it. Thanks for watching, guys. Comment below. Bye.